Thank you for being here. I want to quote briefly from a document from the Ontario Human Rights Commission. It says, some people may not know how to determine what pronoun to use. Others may feel uncomfortable using gender-neutral pronouns. Generally, when in doubt, ask a person how they wish to be addressed. Use they if you don't know which pronoun is preferred. Simply referring to their person by their chosen name is always a respectful approach. So you can use a pronoun, you can use their chosen name. So if someone chooses to change his name from Paul to Peter, surely you would use Peter because it's a matter of simple politeness and respect. If the same person chooses to change her name from Paul to Paula, I won't use the name Paula simply as a matter of respect. I'm just arguing, sir, that you always base whatever you say on what the Ontario Human Rights Commission is saying, and I'm quoting from the Ontario Human Rights Commission document. They're saying, we're not mandating pronouns. You can always use the person's chosen name as a respectful approach.
But then, well, I would say then that's actually an indication of just exactly how poorly the policy documents are written, because I can quote this one, which is also from the Ontario Human Rights Commission website, that says, and I quote, refusing to refer to a person by their self-identified name and proper personal pronoun constitutes gender-based harassment. And so if the policies were written in a coherent manner and there wasn't internal contradictions, then your statement would be a reasonable objection. But since it's not written that way, and I do believe firmly that that's a testament to the degree to which it's a poorly written set of policies, is that it's full of internal contradictions. It's the motherfucking Eagle Double G. Snoop Dogg.